Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Crawl Stone Soup. Okay, so there has been a significant amount of time off. I've basically just been lazy and I haven't really felt like playing. But I've started to play again. And of course there have been comments, many, many comments, telling me to put up more videos and that sort of thing, and I really appreciate that actually. It makes me feel wanted. I didn't really intend when I started this channel to have anybody actually watch the videos. It's been a bit of a pleasant surprise, and I'm nearing 1,000 subscribers now, so I suppose that is some sort of accomplishment. And I suppose now that I have got this ball rolling that I have an obligation to continue it rolling. So I promise to try to be good in the future, or at least better than I have been. To start off with today, we are going to start an unrecommended run. We're going to do an unrecommended run. This has been a character I've been fooling around with and am not good at yet. So expect this to be a fairly short video in terms of in terms of length. And I'm probably going to die horribly fairly quickly. If so, I'll give it a couple of shots just to fill the video out to about 30 minutes or so. But you never know, sort of when I tend to play on camera, sometimes I play a little better than when I'm playing at the office sort of thing. And yes, I have the sort of job where I can play Dungeon Crawl quite often. Alright. Let's choose our class first. We'll do this by pressing spacebar. Of course, we're going to be an enchanter. Now this is my long dream of being a sort of melee character that hexes his opponent, so confuses them and then dashes him with the sword. So we're not going to be using the dagger or any of the short blade abilities. The obvious racial choice for this would be the High Elf. High Elves are good, but they are a little weak, and I want somebody a little more robust. Also, High Elves are best with the long sword, or short sword. So that would sort of gravitate to the normal enchanter sort of character. We want to break away from the stabbing and the stealth. Our options, therefore, are a few. Human, Merfolk, Demon Spawn, to some extent, Gargoyle or Draconian. I like Demon Spawn, but it's a little harder because I'm not good at it yet. I'd rather try something a little more reliable. And I think we'll just go for a human. Let's try that. Okay. We want to ditch the dagger as soon as possible. We're going to turn off everything apart from hexes. Now, there's no sense in training our weapon up yet. We want to get our hexes up nicely, and we want them to be effective. We're going to be relying on the dagger and the spell Corona until we find something a little better. Considering we don't have a lot of strength, come on. Considering we don't have a lot of strength, I think maces and flails, which are readily available on the first level, are probably not a good choice. This could end my run if I try this whip and it's cursed, so we're not going to do that yet. Plus, we don't really want to get into maces and flails since they're a little more strength-based. How much, I'm not entirely sure. Good, we're on level 2 already, and that's part of the reason why I picked human, because of the rapid level advancement. Now here's an interesting choice, pole arms. I think they require strength as well, but we have the reach advantage. Although, come to think about it, what was I going to pick? I think probably staves is our best bet. Unarmed is quite reasonable too. Unarmed would actually be a very interesting choice, but that is a complication I will add for another run, I think, since you're giving up the possibility of having a sky weapon with bonuses on it. So we'll just keep it simple. And I suppose we'll start training our spear up, since I suppose it's compatible with staves, so if we do find a staff, then we can use that. Our training won't go completely to waste. So let's train it up. Also, we are probably going to find a trident at some point, which makes a good weapon. Let's put on this leather armor and drop our plus one robe. Since we are primarily a melee fighter. I probably shouldn't have wasted a corona on... Well, it hurts. No. No. Well, it's him or me. It's about 50-50 now. I have 2 hit points. He is about the same. We keep missing each other. Should I try another corona? Wow, that was close. He deserves to be eaten after that. Okay, let's continue on. We're going to make liberal use of the corona here. And I can't see corona ever becoming a bad spell to use. It's basically a debuff that will always come in handy. I want my intelligence a little bit higher, even though I want the strength and I want the dexterity. We're going to have to get intelligence up to at least 18, I suppose, for now. Let's take a look at the spellbook if I kill him. There we go. Okay, we are going to memorize Confuse right away. That is going to be my bread and butter. Also, Enslavement, Dazzling Spray a little less so, Ensorcelled, Hibernation a little less so. Why less so? I mean, they are good spells, but I want to get my hexes up, and I don't want to bother training anything else for now, because I can't afford it. Our spear, our pole arms is a pathetic 1.2. Oh, here's trouble. Back off a little bit. We're poison, so we're going to go in for a confuse. And we're out of mana. We are more poisoned. Okay. Let's try and wait it out a little bit. We'll probably live. And we did. But that was a little too close for comfort. As you can see, I just tried it twice and our confuse did not work. And that's to be expected. Unfortunately, hexes require a good amount of investment to be useful against high hit dice monsters. And against the highest hit dice monsters, it's pretty useless. So why am I training hexes? Well, because I want to, and there's got to be a way to make it useful. There we go. And for that, for confusing a monster and then just tabbing away at him. Also, I've never actually taken hexes to the limit, as it were. And I'm interested to try that. Confuse, there we go. And tab. Sifmuna is not the god we want in this case, so let's go down to the next level of the dungeon after eating a piece of snake. Our first bit of difficulty is probably going to come on this level. as we face orc packs. What we need to keep in mind is not to charge the entire orc pack. Ooh, axes. It's a nice axe. We've got to try and draw the orcs off one at a time. Especially if there's a priest and a sorcerer. And in this case, they are accompanied by a gnoll who can safely and easily be confused. Let's climb up the stairs. And dispatched. Good. This is a build I've tried many times, and recently I've gotten a little better at it, but I still haven't taken it through the lair. Confuse, and spear him. Now, in order to... my plan for late game... oh, come on. I'm not going to get killed by Crimson Imp for God's sakes. Slow. Run. Run. And now I'm starving. Oh my god. Okay. Let's eat the beef jerky. Can I confuse him? I thought I ate the beef jerky. I didn't. Can't kill him. Maybe if I actually used my Corona, I could kill him, but let's run away for now. Oh, he's still following us. See, this is the thing when you try an unexpected build like this. Things that are usually easy are not anymore. Okay, let's... go away, imp. We're in trouble. Let's eat something. Eat a fruit. And just get away from him. Might have to dive here. Let's dive. Ooh, not a good idea. Back up. Okay, we've got him coroned. And... nope. Not even the mighty Tab can kill him. Okay, we've got to just get away from him. I think we'll just draw him upstairs. Hit him a few times until he blinks. Or I die. Oh, I'm going to come back and kill you, Mr. Imp. Okay, there we go. Well, that was inauspicious. Almost killed by a Crimson Imp. But that's a result of our low skill with the spear. I hope. I think we're going to confuse him as well if we can. And of course we can't. Now, I've tried this build a couple times with elves. And it does tend to go a little better because of their skill with charms and hexes. But I want the versatility of a human to work. It's just going to take a little more investment and a little more luck in getting it started. There we go. Rest up. And I want the extra toughness of a human. Confuse, confuse. There we go. Hey, how did you get back there? Okay, we're improving. We're going to have to start to work on defense eventually. And also spell casting. We've riled up the orc pack. Let's retreat towards the stairwell. Now, sorcerers are very difficult to They've got good magic resistance. I managed to corona him. I think we're just going to drag them up and take them on one by one at this point. Vampiric dagger. Try and confuse him. Oh, it worked. Beautiful. And that's level 6. We did get a point of strength. Let's go for intelligence once more. There's just no choice. No, bad move there. Bad move. There's no way out. Let's climb back down. Try a potion. Metallic, fizzy, cyan, or white. Let's try fizzy. Flight. White. Potion of curing. That helped a little bit. Let's get down here. Hex the first guy. Hex him again. Please die. Run away until we can confuse the second guy. He's throwing stones at us. But he shouldn't be too hard to confuse. There we go. And that's how you survive a very tricky situation. By randomly guessing at potions. Let's not get overconfident. He could use a corona as well. And a confusion. I probably shouldn't have tab fought there, considering I used my one and only curing potion. But at least I have it identified now. Okay, draw off an orc. Corona him and take him down. Confuse the scorpion and tab him. Eat the orc. There we go. I kind of like how Corona grabs their attention too. It's somewhat useful for that. Okay. You, sir, are going to get confused, hopefully. No, you're not, I guess. At least you're going to get coronaed, and I'm severely poisoned. Heal wounds, but I got more poisoned. Wand of slowing is out. Running away is the only option I have, but it's not going to help too much. We're going to run until we can try to confuse him, and that worked. Let's just keep away from him. And there we go. Very close. Again. Well, there's nothing we can do but continue to train our bread and butter skills here. Let's back into the hallway. At least jackals have gotten a little easier since we last fought them. And what's really going to save me here are god abilities. And I'm thinking at this point, Okuwaru. Oh, this is probably closed by now. And I took a step too far there. Let's try to confuse the adder. And hopefully he'll poison the ogre. He did. Excellent. That's what I was hoping for. Confuse him again. Corona this one. No more poison. Please, no more poison. Okay. Let's go see if that sewer is open. I don't think it is. Well, by the way, my headphones broke, so my voice sounds a little different. I'm using my more expensive headphones, or headset, that I don't like very much, but I had no choice. I tried to get the other ones working, but they were held together by duct tape at this point, and they frustrated me, so I threw them away. And then I went to the headphone shop to look for new headphones to buy. And I did buy some, a pair of $10 headphones, because I went expensive and I didn't like the headphones, so I decided to go as cheap as possible. And they turned out to be so horrible that to be all but unusable, really. Confuse you. Oh no. I don't know where we got another potion to heal wounds, but thank God we had one. I don't know if even that will help. And it didn't. I should have attacked there. Huh. Okay. Lessons learned. Orcs are hard. Let's try another run with Procrustes. And this time... let's give ourselves a little bit of advantage. Let's try with a high elf. And we can see the difference. In this case, I'm going to train and use short blades. I know I don't want to go the way of the normal enchanter, but we really don't have a choice. Oh, no. Well, this is not good. I thought this was going to be a lot easier. Yeah, I'm dead. Yeah, there we go. Let's try one more time. So I'm going to use short blades until we find a long blade. And this should be quite a bit easier, actually. Or usually it is. But you never know when you start one of these games. Ooh, a rune dagger. Let's pick that up. And we've got a whole slew of enemies after us. Let's get into a hallway. We're going to try the rune dagger. Dagger of pain, whatever. As long as it works. Apparently it's not working at all. Oh my god. Yeah, okay. One more time. We've just got to... Let's turn off short blades and just train hexes. You can see why this has been a dream of mine for so long. It's a pretty hard build to get started. And this is by no means the only way to start it. You could start as a gladiator, you could start as somebody that's a little better in fighting. Okay, it's level 2. So far, so good. We don't need Sureblade. And we don't need Ensorcel Hibernation. We're going to go right for Confuse. And we are going to use it with zeal. Okay, there's a better short blade to use. Don't get killed by a bat, please. There we go. Maybe we will turn on short blades. We do have a plus 2. Every little bit helps. And short blades are more than adequate for the beginning part of the game. Oh, poison. Heavy duty poison. Yeah. Unless we have a curing, and we do. Unless we very effectively run away. Potion of haste. Well, that will help me escape, but with the level of poison I'm at, let's try this ring. Very nice ring. That helps out, but we're dead again. Okay. We're at about 24 minutes. Let's try one more time. Draconian or Demon Spawn? Let's try Demon Spawn, although I find this very difficult. Maybe this armor will help. It's probably cursed. Oh, plus 3 armor. Well, that helps. Okay. Turn everything off. leave hexes on, and we'll turn on fighting, and we'll focus on hexes. We will also unequip this for fighting, or for throwing. What's that, quiver? Quiver. I forgot how to do it. Okay. No. Oh, there. I was pressing the right button. Okay. Hexes and fighting. What the heck? Demon spawns are at least fairly strong and can use any weapon. We'll pick up these tomahawks in case we need them later. Why not use them? Even with no skill. And I probably should have used Corona at first there, so we will remember to employ our Corona. So what have we learned so far? Ah, yes, keep equipping. We've learned that poison is deadly to enchanters. I think that's how I died every time. We're resistant to cold. That's a pretty good demonic trait to have so far. A better short blade, not better, but actually it doesn't really matter. We'll stick with the plus one dagger. It should hit more rapidly, and the amount of damage at this point with these low level monsters doesn't really matter, as long as we hit them. It's level 3 and 4 before we really get established. That starts to get difficult. Orcs, ogres, and centaurs, and the poison creatures. That's why I'm so desperate to get Confuse reliable. Demon spawns, fortunately, have a lot of hit points. Down we go. I think even more so than humans. So we should prove to be quite tough. Level 3, we'll go for intelligence, and we will get our confuse. Now, there will be people out there saying that I can use ensorceral hibernation without any investment in ice. This is perfectly true. It might even be more reliable than confuse. I probably should memorize it. I have no good reason for not doing so. Don't poison me, please. There we go. Hex is up to level 4. Except at the moment I don't have the... Oh, I do have the spell levels. What else would I want? Enslavement? No, okay, let's just get Ensorcelled Hibernation then. And let's try it. Didn't work. Ooh. Let's back off a little bit. Try to confuse. That worked. Tomahawk. There we go. What I really would like is a poison dagger or a poison weapon. That would work very well in conjunction with Confuse. Let's eat something here. Slice of pizza is good. And our confuse worked. Good. Our corona, however, did not. There we go. Oh, and there's Okuaru. Excellent. An early temple to Okuaru should help out quite a bit here. So this might actually work. Let's not get too excited, though. As you can see there, I pulled off Ensorcelled Hibernation. We're going to get hexes and spellcasting up a little bit now. Our dagger is good enough. I'm not going to invest any more. We've gotten a little stronger, and we've got... Oh, not bad. We've got a shield now. 2 armor class. A +3 leather armor, we're resistant to cold, and immune to freezing clouds. I'd prefer fire, but I'm not going to complain about it. And I'd prefer poison for these early levels. And with both Corona and Confuse, beautiful. Let's not forget to sacrifice them. Goblin we'll keep for later to eat. Since I think we're already beyond the point where Okuwaru appreciates goblin sacrifices. He's a very fussy god. Now, also keep in mind we're looking for a better weapon. Can we confuse him? Yes, well, no. And our Corona doesn't seem to be working very well on this fellow. We managed to fight him off. Let's pick up these needles. We're going to have to use everything we can. Ooh, nice hats. What kind of hats? A +2 hat. Good enough. A ruined ringmail. Our armor class is 12. And confuse is 12. Confuse is 21. And armor class is 13. Not quite worth it. And I don't much care for the brand, although draining can be a bit of a pain in the ass in these new versions, but yeah, we'll just leave it alone. Hi, Terrence. I really wish I had a blowgun. Should we disturb him? He's going to be very, very difficult to confuse. We might be able to stab him very quickly if we carefully take a step towards him. No. And I don't know what types of flail that is, but I don't like the looks of it. We're going to try to confuse him. Didn't work. We're going to try and throw a net on him. That did work. The second one did, anyway. Okay. We should get good bonuses for hitting now. And he's out of the net. Confuse didn't work. And the Corona's worn off already, and now we're out of mana. And we are left fleeing for our lives. Didn't work. Where's the staircase? There. Nothing quick we have to eat, so let's just go upstairs and escape if we can. He's more than likely going to catch up with us. I can't even cast a spell to get away. Escape. Excellent. Let's eat something hearty, meat ration, and we might have to leave Terrence for another time. I hate doing it. But that is how you play crawl, or how most normal people play crawl. I just can't stand leaving him alive. How are we doing anyway? Getting a little better at our spell casting. And what do we have here? A trident. Time to start training pole arms. Let's turn off spell casting for now and focus on our pole arms. And once it gets somewhat skillful, we'll go back for Terrence. Can't forget Terrence. He must not be allowed to go unpunished. Ooh, short sword of venom. Okay. I'm going to switch to that, but continue to train pole arms. Ooh, short blade should at least be one, so let's just train that a little bit. But this will increase our fortunes by a good deal. Poison them up a little bit. Oh, demonic gardening, excellent. And I think I mentioned this, but with this build, if I wanted to augment my attack, I would go for summoning. And have somebody to fight alongside with. Short blades is at one. Let's just turn it off. Axes and spellcasting for now. And I think with our new poison weapon here, we can go take out Terrence. If we can find him. He was last seen somewhere around there, and there he is. Confusion worked. And he is dead. Ooh, wow, he had a flail of holy wrath. That could have been really bad, since I am demonic. Ow. Upstairs. Let's just choose another staircase to go down. And have I forgot to sacrifice? I think I have. I hope Terrence didn't leave a corpse. Okay. Oh no, 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 no. Very foolish. Up we go. That was a little bit dangerous. Poison versus poison. I'm going to sacrifice him. And we'll eat a meat ration. I need piety. I need that heroism ability as soon as possible. That's what I'm really counting on. Let's try and, first of all, let's corona him, and we did confuse him. Excellent. Excellent. That's a level up. Let's go for strength. Yeah, let's go for strength. An icy envelope. Wow. A meltable icy envelope protects you from harm and freezing vapors. Armor class plus 10. Very good. Very, very good. I almost feel invincible now. Look at all my demonic guardians. I've got magic hats. Let's try the magic hat. Now what's after us? Yes, disrobe. Come and get me. And did I pick up that staff? I did. Let's try the hat first. Plus one hat? No. I prefer the plus two hat. Thank you very much. We'll drop that. We'll try the staff. Staff of Conjuration. Now, we are actually going to train staffs. Because that's the weapon I want to use. We will continue to use our poison. I think Duvessa should be taken out first here, but let's see what we can do. These damn elves are so... so magic resistant. Well, obviously I need to step away from these guys. I'll try and get into the hallway here. Excellent. Except Dowan is going to be a real pain to deal with. But not if he's confused. Beautiful, that worked out nicely. We have two corpses. We got a lot of piety for that. And we'll pick up that cutlass of freezing just in case. Okay, good. Things are going well. And had I been sacrificing earlier, I probably would have some Okuaru power by now. Speaking of which, let's try some of these scrolls, since we do have enchant armor. Let's enchant the leather armor up a little more. We do have a god, so it's time to go through our scrolls and potions. Let's try that ring. Ring of Wizardry, yes, yes, very good. Very, very good. We'll memorize enslavement, which will come in handy. And just continue to check these scrolls. Magic mapping, recharging. Could have at least had that before I checked my scrolls. Wand of Flame, not the best, but we need everything to survive. Scroll of Fog, Random Uselessness, Remove Curse, Blink, and Teleportation. And more Tomahawks. Flights, Heal Wounds, Resistance, and Poison. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Now what I really want, and I'm really hoping for, is Crazy Youth. And I'll get a nice staff. Not the best staff, mind you. I don't like the Chaos brand too much, but... So we have Heroism up and running. Good. Our staves are going up. Spellcasting and hexes are going up. Everything is castable. Might not be that powerful yet, but wizardry's helping. No. You leave my sky beast alone. I don't know if he's dead or not. No, apparently not. Now he is. Oh, I guess now he is. Okay. Hex is up to level 6, up to level 7. Our guardian grows in power. Well, I must say this is going quite well. A little bit of luck goes a long way. Yeah. A sun demon. That's just a win button at this stage of the dungeon. As is this poison dagger. This is, or the poison short sword. It's really helping. Ice Devil got him, but, you know, what the heck. And here's a shield. We'll pick that up. Confuse, please. All right, don't confuse, but we've got a huge demon here to help deal with a little ogre. Well, not little, but... Wow. All right, this is cutting into my experience a little bit, but, you know, what the heck. Amulet of Rage is probably going to be very good, too. And that armor class allowed me to plow through that Goliath beetle. We need to evoke what? We need to invoke our Okuaru ability. We'll just get that up a little bit. Staves we can lay off on for a little bit and continue on. There's a nice sword. And here's a nice staff. Staff of Power? You know, what the heck. No, we're going to have to continue to use our poison dagger. Although we don't really now with the demon that summons along with us. Every time we get into trouble, we have a nice demon to help us out. But he's not really that reliable. Okay, anything we haven't read? Fear, immolation, anything we haven't quaffed? Lignification, okay. Try the ring, stealth, yeah, whatever. We'll eat them and hope to get some corpses to sacrifice soon. There's one. We managed. Ah! Confused. Poisoned. Dead. Smoke Demon got the credit, unfortunately, but really, what are you going to do? Yeah, go kill them, Smoke Demon. Kill them all. We got the credit for that one. I should have used Corona. And there's an unsacrificed corpse here. I'll probably get nothing for it. No. I did not. This is going pretty well. There's a decent looking axe there. But we're not going to start training everything under the sun. Invocations is at level 3, that is more than enough. Heroism's down to 1%. I wouldn't mind getting evocation because this Berserk Rage amulet is going to come in handy. That gives me basically trog power. And trog power is nothing to sneer at. Bye-bye, Natasha. I'm surprised I was able to confuse her, actually. And what's good about confusion is you're able to confuse zombies and that sort of thing as well. Evocations is at level 1. Now, what's that going to do for our Berserk Rage? Down 5%. I'm not going to train evocations up too much right now, but just to get that a little more reliable. I've got to sacrifice him. And we'll eat some of our permafood. And another staff. Wow. Staff of Death. Okay. Let's drop some of these staffs because we're not going to need all of them. Power is nice. We'll drop Death and we'll drop Conjuration. And there was this normal quarterstaff up here. Did I pick it up? No. Let's just get that. I think we'll start training our staffs again, too. Let's drop the evocations and drop the spell casting. Let's see how it goes with hexing and staffs. Huh, okay. Not bad. Not bad so far. And those demons are dynamite. Eat the orc. And we have some artifact ringmail. And what do you know? We have a branded staff. Let's try this one. Anti-magic quarterstaff. Well, that is not what we want at all. So let's drop that, and let's just use our normal quarterstaff. Everything's down to 1%. What does the ringmail do? Not much. So we'll keep it on. It's resist elec, and it's also rage. So we can get rid of our amulet if we have to, but we're going to have to train up armor just a wee bit. Especially considering that we want to use our shield. However, right now our armor class is so good that we can delay putting on the shield for quite a while. Might as well eat them, and we're not going to get any piety for them. Alright, well, everything seems to be going very, very well. But you know what? It's going to get harder. Much harder. Down we go. This is the dangerous part. You fall into a bit of complacency. Wow, this game's easy. I'm just running through the dungeon now. And then you run into a situation where you should be thinking a little more, and you don't. And then you die. Wow. Even Crimson Imps are falling beneath my quarterstaff. Level 9. Intelligence, strength, dexterity, what do we want? What do we want? I don't know. I think we're going to have to get intelligence. But I really want strength. And dexterity. I want to make our weapon more effective. Because really, that's what I want our bread and butter to be. No demon. He's mine. And I killed him good. It's not that I don't appreciate your help, demon. I really do. I just want the experience. Let's try this ring. It's probably better than our ring of stealth here. We're not trying to be stealthy. And there's the intelligence what we want. Let's also drop some of this junk here. There we go. Go away. My, have we grown in power. Casually destroying adders. Summoning demons. Do you remember when we started? Dying to hobgoblins on level 1. Okay, let's try enslavement here. Ah, okay, you could probably be enslaved. Go kill him for me. And you get confused. Get confused, please. There we go. Beautiful. Sowing chaos and destruction, making them attack each other. This is exactly what I wanted. And we have a ruined cloak here. What's that going to do? Nope. I was hoping for poison resistance, but that puts our armor class up to 24. Excellent. Down we go. Towards the lair. I've been thinking I always follow the same pattern as well. Always the lair before the orcish mines, that sort of thing. I was going to switch it up a little bit, but on this run, I don't think I will. This is pretty much the most successful I've ever been at starting this sort of character. So we're going to keep it going. I can't remember the last time when I sacrificed a corpse. You die. Yellow wasp, huh? Can we enslave the yellow wasp? Yes, we can. I thought we could use it to poison the orc, but he got away. But he got killed as soon as he started attacking the orc. And this orc is heavily armored. He would make an excellent thrall. There we go. Sacrifice. I got some piety for him. Sacrifice the yellow wasp, some piety from him, and there's the lair. Good. Run through the jackal pack. What's our staves doing? Up to 5, huh? Armor's up to 3, let's turn that off. Let's get some dodging. Spriggan. I can't believe I actually managed to confuse him. Spriggans are known for their magic resistance. And he gave us piety as well. Excellent. You know who'd be easy to slave? A stupid skeleton. Attack him. Thank you. And I will turn my attention to this fellow here. Good work, skeleton. You come here. Hey! How dare you kill my skeleton? Maybe we can slave him too. Yes, we can. Whoa! Luckily, we have slaves. Get the elf. All of you. You are my slave now. You get the iguana. And I'll take the orc. Well, this is a lot. Oh, you're not my slave anymore. Okay, die. This is a lot of fun. This is an interesting playstyle. Slave, attack. Oh, I've got a sun demon now. Well, that pretty much makes it pretty easy. And we just collect the piety. We'll eat an apple or two and continue on. Maybe we can slave you. Yes, we can. Now, let's just confuse you and kill you. Oh, it's like I'm not even playing the game. And that's why I wanted to do this build. That's a lot of fun. However, what we do need to do now is get a lot more melee-oriented. Hexes is fine. Let's get up to 10, then we'll leave it alone for a while. Then we're going to go for staves and dodging. And fighting. And then we're really going to start ramping up the melee aspect of this guy. I'm going to get strength up a little bit if we can. And dexterity up. Rings will come in handy. You can help me. Oh. We've already got some help. Let's just charge in there and kill them all. Uh-oh, no demon. It's okay, now I have a dog. We're going to have to eat one of these wolves, I suppose. And notice I haven't used my Okawaru ability even once. I really should. I've got Berserk Rage too, yeah. Hey, where'd that demon go? Could have stuck around a little longer. We've got a demonic guardian. We've got our massive armor class boost. We've got our cold resistance, and now we have sharp fingernails. Now, I'm not really sure what the fingernails, toes, horns mutations do. I assume that they're only good in melee combat. Let's just poke our nose in here a little bit and see what we have to deal with. Yeah, let's... Do we have magic mapping? We're marked. Let's see what kind of vault this is. That's reasonable. I don't like being marked, though. Not one bit. Luckily, we've got demons on our side. Step back, please. Confuse. So far, so good. Close the door. Hat of fire resistance might be better than our plus two hat, so let's put it on. And it's plus two anyway, so we can drop the other one. Good. Got some nice weapons in here, but no staffs. And thank God for that hat of fire resistance. Without it, we would be fiery right now. Got some piety there, carefully. Let's check the next vault. Might be a good place to have a snack next to this tempest of fire. Ooh. Three hands, yeah. Nevertheless, we will keep that buckler. Get the potions, and let's get out of here. That was certainly well worth it. And now, let's check out what we picked up in terms of potions. Haste. Experience. Ho 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 ho. That is a quaff right now. So, defensive or offensive? Let's put it into staves and spellcasting. There we go. Staves gain 3 levels and spellcasting gain 3 levels. Excellent. We've got claws now and our gloves fall off. Who cares? Let's drop the leather armor, drop the gloves, drop the buckler. Let's equip the Staff of Power, and let's actually just read about these staffs. Damage plus 3, base damage 10. That's a quarter staff. Base accuracy plus 5, base damage 5. Well, it does half the damage, but it is a one-handed weapon. Let's compare it to this, base damage 6. How about this base damage? Well, it's a pretty crappy weapon. Let's try it, though. And that is a good candidate to try it on some yaks. First of all, let's get one of them on our side. Have them fight amongst each other. Confuse this one. What is confuse? That's B. Confuse. Confuse! I'm not sure about the staff. It's not doing the sort of damage that I expect a staff should be doing. Not at all. And where's my demonic guardian? Let's confuse him. Confuse him. Let's heal wounds. Let's get a real staff back. Oh no, that's doing much better damage. Okay. Let's drop hexes for a little bit. No, let's not. Let's not. Let's keep hexes. I don't think there's any reason to ever turn off hexes at this point. And let's try this ring on. Sustainabilities. I think wizardry is going to serve us a lot better. I would like to use that buckler, but there's no way. I'm not going to use that staff. We've got so many options here. I can evoke Berserk Rage. I have Okuaru's ability. I've got claws. And we're still really relying just on our hexes. And that's good enough. They're doing a great job. Not too much to worry about when you got a sun demon with you. Except when that sun demon just disappears for no reason. Okay, that... Getting a little bit dangerous here. Time to enslave. We'll make you go after the yak. There we go. Thank you, sir. You have proven to be a useful ally. And now you're going to get confused and killed yourself. Okay. We're getting near to full Okuaru piety. We have finesse going now. What we want is a little bit of fighting as well. But I'm not going to train four things at once. We might as well just continue on with what we have. Should have eaten him. Didn't get any piety for him. And now we're starving and facing a pack of green rats. Let's eat our fruits and tab our way through these green rats. And that is level one of the lair. We are doing well. Very well. Surprisingly well. Let's drop the paralysis. Drop the buckler. Might as well make a little stash here. We'll keep the wand of flame just in case we have to shoot. And then the magic darts and draining. We have two wands of draining, so let's drop one. Let's get rid of these rings. We're not going to need them. And I think we still have some potions to check out. Berserk Rage. I'm hoping for a beneficial mutation. No. But, really, we're doing pretty well. Okay, let's also drop the Staff of Power. Okay, so far, that is looking pretty good. So, I'm back for now. No guarantees, as I've always said. I do not monetize my channel. So I have no motivation for doing this other than my love of the game and my enjoyment of making these videos. Did I pick up another book here? Ooh, animate skeleton. Animate skeleton. Gotta get it. Wait a second. Okuaru. He doesn't like that. He doesn't like, oh, that's bad. It's my god page. Here we go. Okuaru prefers heroic feats against much stronger enemies and pays little heed to easier victories. Harming one's allies. Oh, you can pray to sacrifice all fresh corpses on your square. Okay, just my square. You can speed up your combat. Okuaru strongly dislikes it when you attack allies. Huh, so does that mean if I don't attack my own allies? Well, we're gonna have to find out. Maybe the hard way. But that's it for now. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.